Greg Dvorsky and Jay Scherz are the men wearing the stripes tonight. No changes in the lineup for the Oilers. A question mark with Fernando Pisani, the leading goal scorer at 10, but he's on the forecheck, number 34 in the dark uniform right there. Only one change for Carolina. Chad LaRose is out at the forward position, and big Joseph Wasicek returns after 12 straight scratch at forward. Peter Laviolette said he wants to create chaos. There is a start on some of it. Two big hits early.
Yeah, Rafi Torres on Commodore, and that's becoming quite a battle with those two. And then Pekka threw a body check also.
Pisani shoves off with Brett Hennigan. Pekka tripped up. Puck jabbed along by Williams, and he moves back out with Corey Stillman and Rod Brindamore to the bench. Replaced now by Duff Waite. The shot by Williams is turned aside and then pitched along by UC Markkanen. And the U chant goes up. UC around behind. It's controlled again by Williams. To Corey Stillman, a shot. And that one went wide and caromed up into the mesh above the glass.
Well, a great start to this one. If you're going to be really physical, don't take penalties. And as you see, Commodore had to see the puck, moved it, and he saw the body check coming up. Torres, who is like a heat-seeking missile, moves in. That's a good, clean body check. Pekka threw one himself on the near side. And we saw a very good first shift. Also, the first shot goes to Carolina with Justin Williams, an underrated player. Sneaky, fast player, had the first shot.
Hurricanes quick to throw pucks at the net. Stillman's was not one of those great shooting opportunities, but he put it on goal anyway, and it got tipped up into the mesh.
Well, Carolina coaching staff said, we didn't shoot the puck enough. We've got to do more of that like we did in earlier series.
Ryan Smith, bothered by Caberle. Trying to knock it loose is Doug Waite, the one-time Oiler for 8 years. Sean Horkoff around behind. He scored the first goal in the other game. Tarnstrom a shot, and that deflected wide. He blasted a deflection that came from Spacek. Yaroslav Spacek with two assists on both of the goals in the victory here two nights ago. Aleš Hemský is run off. Took a stick up high. Keeps going. Away from Ray Whitney, it's back out to Hemský again. Sidesteps the check of Waite. Two assists for him the other night. Cannot work his way through, and it's flexed away by Cam Ward. The spotlight always shines on goalkeepers. Cam Ward seems to love the spotlight. Only 22 and a rookie.
He's amazing. Mike, every time you talk to him, I said, how'd you get through game three here? And him says, no problem. I said, it didn't get to you at all? He said, no. The tougher the situation, the more than what you're seeing with Peter Laviolette. He's taking Stillman off this line, which means he may see some time with Stahl to try to get him scoring. So Peter Laviolette changing things up early for the first time in this series. He wants offensive players on the ice. He wants to get the lead, and he wants to go for it with offense.
Wasicek, 6'5", 215. A difference in size. Pisani. But Pronger at center. Then Pekka. Well, not early chaos established by Carolina, but what does a coach mean when he says he wants chaos?
He wants his forwards to get the puck deep in the Edmonton zone and just flat out go for it. They may give up an odd man scoring rush against, but he feels Cam Ward is such a good goaltender that that's okay. He wants to win a high-scoring game, is what he's saying. His team, when the faster the game is and the more chaotic it is on the ice, he feels the better his team plays. And he doesn't think Carolina skated very well in game three of the series, the last game.
So far, the faster team is the one in the dark uniforms, the home team here.
Biggest thing right now for Edmonton, they know they're shooting the puck in, so they know where to go to retrieve. And when they go retrieve, it's a lot of physical conduct. But God, I gotta tell you right now, Doc and JB, the biggest thing for Craig McTavish, he wants to wear out Brindamore's line, forcing him to defend down low.
They are resting at the bench right now as Doug Waite takes over. The booing is because he was once an Oiler, and it was for economic reasons that he left. He is the first in hockey to ever do that. Here is Wesley ahead now, on to Ray Whitney. Oh, and Wesley was run into by Hemský, and it's played back ahead for Sean Horkoff. Horkoff crossing, drops to Hemský. Hemský fed one to Smith, back to Hemský, was smeared by Andrew Ladd. Now it's across to Smith. Banked one across that is near Dick Tarnstrom. Battling there, though, is Nicholas Wallin along with Horkoff. It's punched onto Andrew Ladd, who registered a big hit for Carolina.
You know, Mike, Hemsky is so talented for Edmonton, number 83, but he won't shoot. Man, he was in a great shooting position, decided to make an extra pass.
Two assists he had the other night. He's got a lot of moves. He reminds you of Maxim Afinaganov of Buffalo that way.
Reminds me of Kovalov of Montreal.
Oh, a good thought off. A save made there by Cam Ward. Spotcheck across to Steos, then with Dvorak. Dvorak with a shot. Save made by Ward. Turning with it in traffic is Brett Hedekin and connects on to Stillman. The follow-up from Mark Recchi, surrounded by Blue. Drive by Stahl. Sprawling block by Spotcheck.
And we're seeing Edmonton have a great start here. Fabulous start to their game. Carolina's going to have to weather this hurricane that's coming against them.
Laid across by Stillman, on to Kaberle, bounced one in front, marking in a little trouble, but then it's helped going out to where Wasichek will go back to get it.
Reason why they're off to this good start, simplification, nothing complicated. John, you talked about chaos from Carolina. You can't have chaos if all you're doing is taking your head right off the plexiglass because they're bouncing you into it.
Ladd sends it in, this time Cullen goes in and closes off Jason Smith. Oh, and then Cullen is set flying by Rafi Torres, and it bounced off the back of the cage, but is covered by Michael Pekka.
The referees are letting them play tonight, aren't they?
They are. H in hockey stands for hits, and there came another from Pekka on Ladd. Lifted back in by Cullen.
Edmonton wants to wear out Carolina with physical play. Carolina wants to wear Edmonton out with speed. We'll see if they're able to do it.
Rod Brind'Amour's line is out there. Brind'Amour, number 17, leading goal scorer in the entire playoffs with a dozen. Cleared on back for Hedekin. Brett Hedekin, St. Cloud State. Mike Commodore out of the University of North Dakota. They have played some catch with it, and Williams flings one that goes down and will be an icing touch-up.
For the Oilers, and early on in this game, they got it going.
6-5 in favor of Edmonton. Theirs have been the louder ones, greeted by the applause of the crowd. Michael Pekka with some big hits at 5'11", only 190 pounds, but a large part.
Yeah, he doesn't know he's 190 pounds. In fact, this time of year, he might be 180. Thinks he's 225. He always has.
Here he comes in on Hedekin and reached it away from him to Pisani. Hooked it off the back of the cage, protected pretty well there by Corey Stillman. Oh! And a surprise pass, and a big goal went up from the crowd here as Hedekin can eventually settle things down, and it's Stillman bringing it ahead. Into the glove and out again, paddled by Markkanen.
When you throw the puck in, you don't want to throw it at the goaltender. Edmonton's been good at that. They have not allowed Cam Ward to handle the puck much. Maybe he will here.
Shoveled it back. Aaron Ward turned it over now to Frank Kaberle, and Kaberle's toss is to Waite. Set up for Matt Cullen. Cullen swaggering, couldn't get the shot away. Spotcheck doing the number on him defensively. Then Cullen again, reaching in as Ray Whitney. One-time Edmonton Oilers stick boy in the uniform of the Hurricanes. Around now it's turned by Doug Waite. Could not get it through Spotcheck. What a job done defensively by him in this series. Kaberle played it on. Pulling free and letting a backhander go that time was Cullen. Another one, and that one turned aside in front by the defense. Big George LaRocque handed it across to Ethan Morrow. The energy guys are out there for Edmonton, but Morrow can't get it through Aaron Ward.
And LaRocque's got to be sure he doesn't take a penalty, Mike. He only played three shifts in the last game. 24 seconds total playing time. He's big, he's tough, he's mean, but he's got to stay on the box.
6-3, 2:55. A shift change, but George is still out there, and offside is called.
Not about how they won everything, but what happened when they lost, and how they took losing, and how it wasn't acceptable to lose. But you can learn a lot from people with that sense of seeing how people deal with losing.
Kevin Adams shoved off, worked over pretty effectively by Matt Green, the rookie out of North Dakota. Along now comes Recchi. Jarrett Stahl checking him. Recchi fed for Adams, right back for Stahl, and it's the Oilers to outlet. Sergei Samsonov brings it ahead. Little opening, twist of behind the back pass. Captain in front, they score!
Vallin not staying with Samsonov.
His first point of the series, and off the resulting draw, a penalty coming up to Rafi Torres that will result in a Carolina power play. But right now, a delayed call on, and so the extra attacker out, and it is touched by the Oilers.
Boy, oh boy, first shift. Off a goal scored by your club, and down on the bottom you see Williams there, and Torres just reached out and pulled his feet out. Carolina's power play, coming off a game where they were 0 for 5, have got to get their power play going here in Edmonton. Otherwise, that's a major part of their offense missing, Pierre.
It really is, John. Watch for number 12 on the right point. Eric Staal to be a factor. They're trying to get him to the inside part of the ice. They want him just simplifying things, shooting pucks on goal, trying to get rebounds. And here he is with the puck now.
Torres the trip at 8:57. It's given on to Corey Stillman. Nicely to the back to Staal. Handed across to Caberle. Good guy. And does it grab and score! Corey Stillman on a clean pass across from Caberle. And the game is tied at one. A power play goal for the Hurricanes.
Boy, what a goal by Stillman. And he started it actually with the puck over on the left side. You're going to see him get the puck there. Now, it's going to be double-teamed here in a moment. Two players are going to go up towards him right here. And look at the pass he made. Now they forget about him. And look at that pass across for the one-time shot. We're tied at one. That was a bad, 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 lazy penalty that Torres took to allow Carolina to fire up their power play. And baby, was it moved nicely. What a pass across by Caberle. And there you see the shot on the short side by Stillman.
Two close quarter goals scored here. The first by Edmonton, the second by Carolina. Pierre,
we talked about the slick passing, but you see the little adjustment. You see how 12 gets to the middle of the ice. That opens everything up.
None.
And 48 hours had to pass. Much of that time, waking hours, and sometimes sleep doesn't come too easily. Waits, pass is cut by Hemsky, has Smith, controls himself, and gives to Horkoff. Then Smith. Horkoff put the shoulder into Caberle. Meanwhile, it's played by Doug Waite. Waite flips it on ahead. Caberle steered it further, but Matt Green out of Grand Leds, Michigan, near Lansing, saw that play develop ahead on his pass. Turned right back across. Hemsky, another behind the back pass. This one is cut by Ladd. A penalty has been called. It is a trip. We'll be back with another power play right after this.
They've been for tripping.
That and hooking are among the more prominent calls these years in the playoffs, especially this spring where hooking has been a quarter of it. Spacek's pass is broken up, and Rod Brind'Amour, power play, penalty kill, everything is out there.
Well, it's 18 of 22 calls against Carolina in this series that have been for restraining or tripping type calls. 18 of 22.
So you talk about the power play. Here's Horkoff dropping it on back across now for Smith and the bouncer near Pronger. Then Horkoff, one for the last 20 on the power play for the Oilers. Brought ahead now by Kevin Adams. Adams a shot that's deflected wide by Spacek. A change for Carolina. Ward comes out to play along with Vallin. Craig Adams along with Brind'Amour. Ahead comes Sergei Samsonov, scorer of the first goal. Wanted to take his own pass, canceled out neatly by Ward, and it's clear.
Brind'Amour started the penalty kill, went off the ice for about 10 seconds. Back on. The man never stops. He goes at the same speed all the time. Chris Pronger said he doesn't have a top speed, but it's the same speed, and he never seems to tire.
Lifted along by Pekka, taken by Jarrett Stoll, given to Tarnstrom, to Stoll, quickly to Samsonov. He's got a man open. Pisani decides to go deep to Pekka. 37 to go, man advantage. Tarnstrom lobs one that skipped in on goal, carefully covered by Ward.
See how the Carolina Hurricanes are coming out and overplaying on the Edmonton Oilers point, man. What the Edmonton Oilers are trying to do right now is get somebody in the high slot, John, so they have a little outlet for their defensemen. They know they can't get pucks through, so they're looking for that little chip pass to the seam in the slot.
Yeah, you're right, Pierre. Actually, Tarnstrom tried that during the last portion of the power play. Only 32 seconds to go on it now. And the puck was unfairly dropped. You know, earlier in the series after game one, Edmonton was really upset with the way Carolina was winning so many faceoffs, in particular Brind'Amour, and he was good, great at it. So the Oilers actually had the NHL bring people in to show them what was legal, what was not legal. The key, though, when you're at home here, Brind'Amour has to ground his stick first on the ice. Visiting players stick down first, and that gives the home team an advantage to try to time the dropping of the puck, because a little delay here is they're putting time back on the clock. 1 second, they've now gotten it back on. So let's watch and see if Brind'Amour, yes, he sticks down first. If he was at home, he wouldn't do it.
Off this draw, it is held by the defense, and Tarnstrom over for Hemsky, hit pretty solidly by Commodore. Diving play is kept alive. Drive by Rockoff! Oh, that rattled off Hennick and Wood sprawl. Now Pronger again, back onto Hemsky. Quarter of a minute to go on the power play. Pronger rips it across. Played back again to Harkoff. Tipped it away from Pronger and back out.
That was what Pierre McGuire was talking about. The man in the high slot, that was Harkoff. It almost worked.
It is played by Harkoff again. Got it through to Smith. Smith drops it onto Tarnstrom. Penalty time is up. Ryan Smith banks it back to Tarnstrom again. Around for Smith. Met by Hennigan. Centering pass skipped on. Kept alive by the Oilers, but bounced near Commodore. And he rips it back out. And it careened all the way back down. But they are saying no icing on this. Good hit by Andrew Ladd. Lead strongly for the Hurricane forecheck. Lobbed back out by Morrow. Carried on by George Laroque. Played in for Rem Murray. Unable to sweep it as Ward. Murray hit. Laroque there. Wait on him. Wesley intercedes. A four-man scrum. 7 1/4 to go first period. Both teams struck inside of a half minute apart. Another healthy hit and a shot that went just wide. A strong shot from the point by Steve Steos. And it's controlled by Spacek. Misfired for Murray. And a giveaway to Rem Murray, who starts back in. Hooked. There'll be a penalty coming up. It'll be against Carolina. Another Oiler power play.
That'll be Whitney going. He overplayed the puck, Mike. He had the puck outside the blue line, brought it back in, tried to do something extra, lost the puck, and
into the high slot for a one-time chance.
Pretty good chances afforded on the last power play. A couple of those to the high slot, but here is Smith around behind, then Hemsky. That pinball in front. Oh, trouble for Pauline, but he got enough on it to scoop it away where Harkoff retrieves. Then Pronger. Bounced onto Smith. He's got Hemsky deep. Smith holds, though, and then is worked on by Pauline. Took it right back over again. Nicholas Pauline makes them chase it. Well, it sure sounds easy. Get it to the guy in the high spot.
Well, you try plays, you look at videotape, you try to find a weakness or an open seam, and then you try to execute it. Good play there by Commodore with a long reach. Offside. Mike, a couple of nights ago after game three, Kevin Lowe, the general manager and former player, that's him. No, that's Glenn Anderson actually sitting up there with Mark Messier. But anyway, there was a bit of a house party at Kevin Lowe's home with all the ex-Oilers and people, and then when they all left. Mark Messier stayed at Kevin Lowe's home. Kevin would let him leave. And he sat down and looked at a tape of game three, and they studied the power play. And Kevin was trying to get the input of Mark Messier and how to make their power play better. So he was giving them some thoughts and ideas, and we'll see if the Edmonton Oilers are able to implement any of those.
1:05 to go in the second one, but the Hurricanes' penalty kill has been strong so far. It'll be Tarnstrom and Pronger, Samsonov, Pekka, as well as Rafi Torres. Lob back in by Pronger. Wesley moves back and shoulders there with Samsonov. Misfired on a pass for Torres. Skated back out again by Kevin Adams. Product of Miami of Ohio's hockey program. Played it right back in.
It gets the two Adams, who don't play a lot picking offense, gets them into the game when they have to kill some penalties like this.
Sean Harkoff brings it on in the last half minute of this advantage. Tarnstrom recovered. Back on to Spacek, who's hurried in from the bench. Hemsky then on the cycle. Harkoff to Tarnstrom, and anticipating that very well and then clearing it was Kaberle. Along to Harkoff. Oh, he took some lumber from Vallin. Down to the last nine of the power play. Racing back ahead is Hemsky. It's knocked back to Harkoff. Shuttled back out. Charging ahead for it is Eric Staal. Moving in. Putting on the brakes. It's Staal beating Aaron Ward. Fed one in front that's canceled right out. Off the stick of Williams. And right back ahead with it comes Ryan Smith. Teams back at full strength. Hemsky, weak toss. Cut off and flung along by Glenn Wesley. The follow-up from Pronger. Then to Smith. Hit by Wesley. Threw it to the back. Pronger settles it down. They want him to shoot, and he does, but it went off Jarrett Staal.
I love the idea of Pronger using the wrist shot as we have another penalty coming up. Again, it's Whitney, I think. It's another hooking call.
Underway on the power play, which is 0 for its last 15.
2 minutes for hooking. The time, 15 minutes, 35.
Frank McTavish is telling his team right now, it's not about when we get in the zone, it's about how we get into the zone, and he keeps stressing that to his players. Shoot it in and retrieve it, just as Ponder did there, hoping for Pekka to retrieve as he did.
It is Samsonov, pinching in his spot check. Wedged off by Brindamore. Off of Wesley, skipped further, and Michael Pekka nicely finesses to Torres, and they can keep possession. Samsonov dealt it on back to Rafi Torres again. Then it's Samsonov. Watched by Brindamore, then by Aaron Ward. Pacek again. Pekka put it right on goal. And another penalty is coming up. A high-sticking call. It'll be a 5-on-3 for the Oilers.
For a minute, 12 seconds. They had a big one in the previous game. They've had trouble with their 5-on-3s. And Carolina, they're getting into a lot of trouble here as their defensemen are being worked and worked and worked. Aaron Ward is going to go, Pierre.
John, that was part of the philosophy that Craig McTavish brought into game number four. We talked about it early on. Pucks in deep, start pile driving their defensemen, start to frustrate them, get the grinding game going. You said it best. Carolina likes a streak game. They don't like to play a physical game. The Edmonton Oilers are frustrating them right now, and there's a high stick. The frustration level is high on the Carolina bench.
In the series, Edmonton now has its fourth 5-on-3. They have come up empty on the prior three. They are 3-for-17 in the entire playoffs when they get these two-man advantage. Pronger holder has stalled. Also Hemsky deep. Given back by Horkoff. Pronger and drive. Pat stop made by Ward, and it's lifted out. And retrieving his stick now is Commodore.
What a jump by Commodore, pushing Smith out of the way so Ward could see the shot. Also watch for Stoll with a one-time shot off the pass.
Hemsky. Pauline, and play continues. Hemsky gets up and has a word with Brad Watson, the referee.
The referee was 4 feet away. Didn't think it was a penalty.
It is Horkoff crossing. Close quarters over to Hemsky again. Spun on back to Jarrett Stoll. Half a minute left on the 5-on-3. Given on to Hemsky again. Smith right in front of the goaltender Ward. Stoll a drive, and it hit off Smith and ricocheted wide. Hemsky once more. Back it comes for Jarrett Stoll, then over to Hemsky. Still at the front door is Ryan Smith. 10 to go on the first penalty. Stoll playing some catch with Pronger. Drive! Save! Ward! To the last 4 seconds of the 5-on-3. Hemsky there again. Hurling with it. He's got Stoll. It's now a 5-on-4. Given on to Hemsky once more. Back to Stoll. Stoll angles one. Punched away by Vallin. Grabbed off by Pronger. 38 to go in the 5-on-4. It's Horkoff dealing it in. Ryan Smith banked one off the defense. Another try forced away by Vallin. And lost by Pronger. Stepping ahead is Whitney. He's got a trailer. Kevin Adams. Whitney holds. Crosses. Drive. Save. Rebound. Couldn't get the shot away. What a number done by Hemsky on the rebound. Play back in. Ryan Smith. Is this the chaos they were talking about? Oh, healthy hit on Williams by Pekka. Smith without a stick. Hit hard there by Hennigan, and it's cranked back down. 3 seconds, 2 seconds left on the 5-on-4, and the box is empty. Whoa. Back ahead comes Stales in this 1-1 tie with a minute and a half to go in the first. Played back in near Aaron Ward. Up with it, Rim Murray. Intercepted by Ward and laid back off for the carry on by Wasichek. Hands it on to Stillman, who moves in. Oh, offside.
This is awesome. Flat out awesome.
Eric Stahl to draw at center this time with Rim Murray. And a false start, so they'll do it again. The Dodge Intermission Report coming up. Bill and Ray and Eddie break down the first period. An inside look at Carolina's Eric Stahl about to take this draw. That's coming up in just a minute. 16 seconds of playing time on the Dodge Intermission Report. Morrow and Stahl, and a lot of jousting between Rem Murray and Joseph Wasichek as it comes on back for Stales to take.
Boy, with Morrow ever giving it to Stahl off the faceoff. Cross checks to his back.
Steve Stales and Spachek have been a team since 4 games remained in the regular season. A tremendous defense there. The secondary won a healthy hit by Morrow, that time on Caberlay. Stahl came by. Morrow nearly got it loose, and then it's banked right back up to the point for Stales' drive that is slowed down and curled by Wasichek. He's able to get it to center to Stillman, then on to Aaron Ward. Drive deflected up into the mesh by Spachek.
at 8, but they've had so many power play chances, you'd think they'd be around 15 or 16. The Oilers have had 5 of their 8 shots on the power play, but they're 0 for 4, including another long 5-on-3, Mike.
They're going to be shorthanded now. Interference is called against them off the faceoff.
Jarrett Stoll wins that faceoff, and then he gets caught for obstruction on Matt Cullen. It's a simple play right off the faceoff, and everything was orchestrated perfectly from the Oiler bench.
Let's take a look at the replay. He's the centerman. And he holds up his man. That's Cullen. Stick into the midsection, parallel to the ice surface. So the Hurricanes were 1-for-1. Pardon me. Yes, 1-for-1. Now have a chance. But remember, only 39.4 seconds to go in the period. Face-off important here.
Doug Waite has Recchi nearby, wins it cleanly to the back to Caberlet. Nudged back over for the play by Waite. Went on through Williams, but is corralled and then just nudged back on for Stoll. Given back for Recchi, then Caberlet. Trying to get by Pekka. Caberlet a shot, and it's deflected in front off of Waite. Drilled back off Caberlet and down. To the last 10 of the period. Stoll moves ahead. Has Whitney and Gibbs to him. It's finesse through to Recchi, but offside with 5.3 left to go.
So what do you think of this first period?
Well, it was chaotic at times.
Yeah.
Then it settled down a little bit. Then we started to get this succession of power play.
Second half of the period, it's been a lot of power play work. And the Oilers, they now, I think, are 1-for-20 going in, and they're 0-for-4. They're 1-for-24, Pierre, in this series so far.
Peter Laviolette's very upset with Brad Watson. He thought that Pekka obstructed in the neutral zone on Dougie Wade on that last sequence. He was just giving it to him big time.
In other words, he wants a 5-on-3, too. Of him on the ice surface, and it acts like a tripod, and he can lean on the stick to try to knock the person over. It's difficult.
A legend named Dave Andrichuk used to earn a very good living that way, didn't he?
Sure did.
Helps to have that height and that bulk. But here is Stoll on the power play. Stillman has extended his point-a-game streak to 12 now, 15 points in that time. He is number 61 in white. He's just passed it over to Caberlet, and then on now to Williams. Then Markkanen, then Pronger, waiting his stall, dropped it on off the stick of Brindamore, nudged back on to Stillman, then to Brindamore again. They fan it out a little bit, giving it on to Stall. Then Brindamore. Brindamore dealt it over. Stillman put it off of Markkanen, and the bouncer is corralled by Caberlet, and he sent it just wide of the pipe.
Well, they moved the puck around quick. This Carolina power play, awesome.
Stall dealt it in. Stillman up with it there. Gave it on to Williams. Sent it over to Caberlet. Wanted that pass across. Denied. Thrown to the front, and Markkanen got his glove on that. Stillman able to turn with it to the last 20 of the power play. Another collision in front. Players go down. It's lifted back out by Pronger.
That was Justin Williams knocked down as he had a nice pass to him in front. Carolina two or three different times. Nearly finished.
To the last 7. As Hedekin lays it across to Commodore. Grabbed and held by Markkanen. That takes care of the...
To take some pressure off their own defensemen. Their defensemen have been overworked here early in this game.
You can view more analysis previewing Game 5 of the Stanley Cup Finals in a Charles Schwab conversation that can be viewed only online at NBCSports.com. Charging ahead is Matt Cullen, taken out by a pair. Cullen reaching for it, but Smith played it off of him. Then Waite, but Tarnstrom shuffled it ahead, and Ryan Smith nudged it, but away from Hemsky. Regathered by Cullen, slides it right back across, and it's played in by Whitney. Develop a forecheck. Maybe it will happen here. Along to Whitney. Then back to Waite. Out to Whitney in front. Cullen, a shot and a knockdown by Markkanen, and the rebound. He couldn't get home, and a 3-on-2. Fed on back now to Ryan Smith. Get it across. Hemsky got through. Save Ward! Rebound scramble in front. It's off of Horkoff and brought back the other way. Maybe an odd man rush. The Oilers do get three back. Andrew Ladd crosses, and offside is called.
Carolina wants chaos, and you may have to give up.
Craig McTavish loves the way Sean Horkoff went to the net. That allowed Ryan Smith to move the puck to Hensky. That's a perfectly executed 3-on-2 by the Edmonton Oilers because of the unselfish play of Horkoff.
After this is Ladd moving in with Steos. Follow-up comes from Dvorak. Good crunch on him that came from Wasichek. Well, they're following through on your command. The third one, establish a forecheck. It's getting better.
You're right, Mike. Two shifts in a row, Carolina's had the puck deep. Here they do it again. Let's see what they can take the body, create the turnover. There it goes.
Recky plays it around for Andrew Ladd. Moving in is Aaron Ward. It's punched away from him, and Caberle retreats to play. Big George Larocque on the forecheck, and Caberle safely behind the net. That one slowed down by Brindamore. Chopped along and hacked back near Jason Smith. Oilers captain slid it across to Pronger. Another change. They get Brindamore, Stillman, and Williams out. Larocque is there. Fitted across and fanning on it as it was elevated. It was Moreau. Now it's brought right back again, and Brindamore moves in. Oh, Ethan Moreau with a great chance there, and a penalty is coming up.
Holding call, Evan Denoy. Good thing about that, though, is he doesn't kill penalties much, so they'll be able to get his skate back to him. You know, there's two morals with Edmonton. One is the strength coach, and one is Ethan. Ethan says Moreau, the strength coach, his brother says Moreau.
Feed to Brindamore, oh, and a remarkable save is made by Markkanen as he sprawled and lifted his legs and may have gotten it with a skate. Back the other way they bring it. Short-handedly played back in by Horkoff. Tries to deal it behind. Good collision there from Brett Hedekas. Still they battle. Knifed away from Horkoff, and Stahl can settle it down with 40 gone.
Oh, did you notice how I picked like three different versions of the pronunciation? Glad he's in the box for now. Brindamore across to Stillman. Right to Brindamore, but it's blocked by Stales in a good play. Stahl in front. Sent it wide. And it's cleared back down.
So now they settle it down on the penalty kill, do the Oilers, by clearing Morrow and Pekka, as well as Spacek and Stales. Around it came for Caberle, picked up by Ethan Morrow, brings it right back ahead. Morrow has Stales with him, but it's an offside play.
This might give us a chance to look at execution.
42 left on the kill. Doug Waite. But away from Caberle. Rem Murray brings it on back. Pitches it back in again and around to play it as Matt Cullen. Nicely able to step away from one. Leads it on ahead. Charging ahead is Recky in a 3-on-2. Recky fed it across. It's given over to Cullen. Right back for two. Great save by Markkanen on Ray Whitney.
Oh, baby.
Played right out in front again, and Recky turns with it. 8 to go power play. Swung back across to Cullen again. Now Caberle across to Recky. Sent one in front, came back to Cullen. Penalty box is empty. Pronger is out. Flipped ahead by Cullen. Blocked back down and cleared by Pisani.
The Carolina power play's awesome. Two great shots. Only Markkanen and the goalkeeper made two fantastic saves.
Commodore shot save. Made there by Markkanen, and it's played along by Wallin off the stick of Kevin Adams. Pronger lifts it back down. Pierre, what do you think?
John talks about the spectacular puck movement of the Carolina Hurricanes, but there comes a time when a great save and a great penalty kill can elevate the spirit of your team. You see the four-man wave coming at the Oilers goaltender, UC Markkanen. What a spectacular save, going from his right to his left, double stack, puck goes wide of the net, but this is going to elevate the spirit of the Oilers bench. I'm there right now, they said, boys, we just killed this off, now we go attack their guy.
Oh boy, if I was Carolina though, I'd feel pretty good about my power play too. Doug Waite drove to the net and took Tarnstrom out of the play. What a great save that was by Markkanen. Four wonderful passes by Carolina.
Kevin Adams at the half board, sped it around behind, turning as Craig Adams. Watched by Pronger. Dealt back to Commodore again. Through Wasilchuk, but taken by Spacek. Kevin Adams lobs it back in again. And Spacek once more connects with Pronger. Edmonton-born Pete Peters is the goaltending coach here. Boy, does he ever have calm resolve, too, when he's talking about Markkanen. Turned around now by Pronger, and Chris Pronger for the Oilers lifted one that came off the glass, sped back ahead. But calm is what Pete Peters was in the many years he played in the NHL, too.
Mostly with Philadelphia and Boston.
This is Corey Stillman. Shoots one, blocked off by Markkanen. worked for by Williams, and he's able to turn to the outside. Williams backhands it on to Stillman. Looks for Williams. It's banked loose off Market, and they jab at it away. But it is Spacek laying it back along to Harkoff. Outlet pass is brought back ahead and nudged on by Smith to Hemsky. The denial, but the follow through by Hemsky, and it comes to Smith. Challenged by Ward. Held back along by Brindamore. Kept by Pisani for Stahl, and it's off Ward. Taken again and played along by Pisani. Off of Smith, grabbed by Harkoff, handed on back to Tarnstrom, gives to Stales. Again, the challenge, it came this time from Stillman. Knocked down by Smith, but he could not control. Stepping to it is Aaron Ward, brings it back the other way. Almost began the night without any hockey sticks. Broke 12 in 3 weeks and had to get a new batch, and they were hard to find. The crossover and the shot slithers in on Ward from Rafi Torres, and he hangs on and then puts it back into play.
Aaron Ward found some new sticks at a store in New Jersey. Shipped them to Raleigh. They'll be there for him tomorrow.
This is Stahl. Oh, and it's off the outside of the cage. Stahl up with it again. Backhands it. Commodore shot, and it went just wide. Brought back ahead by Dvorak. And again, pushed on through Hedekin.
This Carolina game is up-tempo now. This is the game they want to play. They're doing everything but finish.
It is Hedekin, but then Torres. The lanes are blocked, and it caroms back down and will go for an icing. Well, you're right. They tend to be a...
Right now, Carolina's dominating them with their speed and their skill.
Stales a shot, and it went wide.
Stahl beat Stahl clean on the draw. Peter Laviolette can't use Brindamore in every faceoff, so he knows that for Stahl out there, Stahl has just got to learn. And he has to go through the experience. He's not going to pull him off. He has to learn how to play these big games as a centerman taking faceoffs. That's what the coaching staff is telling us.
A collision and a penalty coming up, and who will go? It will be Brett. Good help, Pierre. Thank you. So the power play on for the Oilers in this 1-1 tie. Spacek angles one in front and pushed wide. Oh, a good combination play, but it failed as Ryan Smith directed it wide, and it's cleared into the glove of Pronger. Right back on it comes to Samsonov, but offside is called.
Well, the Oilers' power play has got to click for them in a 1-1 game nearing the midpoint of the second period. They may have to call Wayne Gretzky next.
To look at tape?
Yeah. To give them some hints. Wayne is re-up, by the way. Congratulations to him. He'll be the head coach for a long time with Phoenix. Now, there's the penalty down the lower side. And then the puck moves up. The whistle sounds. And there's the arm going up by Bill McCurry. I don't know. That was a strange one to me.
34th game in the Stanley Cup Final alone for Bill McCreary, working with Brad Watson, third year for him. That one deflected back out again. Remember, Pierre in the pregame show was talking with Rod Brindamore, asking him about the officials' calls and how you have to let it go. Dealt back in, and Hemsky is there. To the side. Still early in this Oiler power play. 0 for 4 with 5 shots, including a 5-on-3 power play in the first. Not much happening on it just yet. Samsonov dealt it back to Hemsky, ripped it on back now for the carry by Pronger. Then back on for Samsonov. Pronger is shot! Knocked down by Ward! Tries to cover and does!
Big time save.
Another important faceoff win for the Oilers. 3/4 of a minute to go on their power play. Commodore along to Brindamore. Lifted it, but into Tarnstrom, Pisani, and then back it comes to Pronger again. Immediate challenge came from Williams. Commodore got in the way. Would not let a pass go through for Torres, and it's laid out by Williams.
Like two hard hits by Commodore on Pisani. Pisani's playing hurt. He hasn't practiced. He was questionable for this game. And Pisani getting hit twice like that. You gotta wonder how much he can take.
Flipped off the glove of Wesley, and Pisani got to it. Hit by Wesley, goes down slow to get up. Nudged onto the back, stole a shot, and getting in the way of that was Kevin Adams. Now Harkoff spun it to the back. Tarnstrom gives on to Stahl, then over to Harkoff again. 2 seconds and 1. Penalty, a timeout, stole a shot, diving in the way of it was Wesley. Trying to swim and knock it along was Craig Adams. And a healthy hit again came on Pisani after he had wedged that backhander toward the goal. lifted along, and it is Aaron Ward descended behind a Wesley, who got stolen on the near boards of Mahoga.
Boy, I know one thing. Kasani got hit four times during that Edmonton power play. Four.
Kevin Adams ahead, crosses, surrounded by Oilers, and it's set up by Markkanen. Brett Hedekin was the guy who registered that big hit on the boards, as this one has popped high and came on back to it. So now 8.5 to go, second period, 12 shots to 11, Edmonton. In this period, 4 for the Oilers and 7 for Carolina. Dvorak has to rag it center and then lay it back in. Hacek and Steos, the defense, they have to turn in tandem to go and get this. Laid by Steos to Spacek, and swooping for that one is Stahl. Nudged on back, Spacek again. This time he connects with Morrow, and it's brought back ahead by Dvorak. Dvorak's pass is spiked away by the ever-present Mike Commodore, and it's Recchi feeding it on to Stillman for a shot that's into the catching glove of Markkanen.
Well, we've
139. The chant earlier with those pom-poms they were waving was Ward, Ward. I'm sure that Cam appreciates that, being a local guy and having been an Oiler fan at one time.
That's a compliment.
That's right.
That means he's playing well, and they're trying to get inside your head. He won't climb inside his. He's level, and he is unflappable.
Alex Hemsky ahead, drops it back off, got the return, unable to get it through, though, and it is lifted back out again by Commodore, cranked back in by Karnstrom. When Mike Commodore appeared in the 2004 Stanley Cup Finals with the Calgary Flames, and has he ever become an important player to these Carolina Hurricanes, that pass is directed right back down and Ward will watch as Hedekin comes in. Not only for his defense, he's a part of the big unit that plays against some of the veterans. Oh, that left behind by Markkanen and swept back out by Pronger again. Torres gave it across and a shot right on goal by Pisani. So he can bang into the guy, and that was a strong shot that he just let go. Skipped around now for Pekka. Tucked one off of Ward. Reached in front by Torres. Shot to the half boards. Jason Smith moves in. Leaned on a bit by Stillman. Smith around behind his hip. Pekka centered off a skate back to Pronger. And again to the outside. Asani had dropped back on defense because Smith had moved in so deeply. But it is Williams now. Things settling a bit as Brindamore brings it on. Rod Brindamore with one that went off the stick of Smith. Brushed around behind and Pronger took over. Lifted it along now to Torres. And Torres left for Pronger, who brought it ahead.
Rod Brindamore's line leaves the ice. So does Pronger and Jason Smith, the defensive pairing. As that continues as a matchup throughout this series, Brindamore has been brilliant. A deeper team scoring-wise. Game settled down. I think that's advantage Edmonton.
Spacek with a drive that's deflected back out by Williams. Good cancellation by Spacek. A six-time member of the Czech Republic's World Championship squad. Steos lays this one right back ahead. Brought in by Dvorak. Vahlin on him. Nicely knocked away by Vahlin. Stoll can't follow up. Spacek can. And that one blocked aside by Vahlin. Now Samsonov, and that one slowed down by Eric Stahl, and then Stahl takes the pass ahead, and it's nicely picked free by Recchi. Richter is grabbed by Markkanen. Time to listen to our sounds of the game brought to you by Sprint, courtesy of Chris Pronger of the Oilers.
What's up? Hey, oh. Go over there.
Chris Pronger in control of positioning, telling the linesman to get out of the way. Well, Markkanen and Pronger were telling me that it gets so loud during play that they don't talk a lot during play, but during the stoppages is when you can have the communication with your teammates. Take advantage of the quiet times.
It will be loud at the next place that we're going to in tonight. The chance in front after the initial stop by Ward. They get it going, those Caniacs down in Raleigh, too. This is Whitney. Through Tarnstrom. Tarnstrom able to pull away from Wasicek. Chopped away by Wasicek, but right up to Hemsky. Sped it on through just by Tarnstrom. He's in with Ward. 4:45 to go. Second period, still 1-1. The goal scored in less than a half minute at one point in the first. Back up with it, Ray Whitney. Near the end of his shift, holds now. A change in defense for Carolina as Wasacek moves in. Wasacek could not get a centering pass away. Good double teaming there, and Matt Green brings it on. Now Horkoff.
Wasacek does not have a lot of energy. He had total knee reconstruction, missed most of the season. Stamina could be a problem.
He had not played in the last 12 games, was used for one game in the New Jersey series, and then back out once more. Here's a grab by Stahl. In front, Recchi score! Mark Recchi has broken the tie with 4:04 to go in the second.
Now they forced Pronger. Pronger turnover. You handle up Carolina leads.
Recchi, a Stanley Cup champion in Pittsburgh in 1991. One of four Carolina players to have won a championship before. Earlier it was mentioned that the coaching staff has been prominent in collecting rings here in Edmonton, but no players yet. And only Michael Pekka has participated in a final earlier, and that was for Buffalo in 99. He brings it ahead. Pekka controlling, threw one off the pad of Cam Ward. Mark Recchi's 47th career playoff goal has broken this tie. Laid back onto Rafi Torres, then it is Ponger back to him. Pekka, shouldered by Wesley, tried to brush one, but getting back deep was Brind'Amour.
Carolina great in their own zone, Mike. They may have a defenseman that doesn't have what you term a big superstar, but are they ever good as a group? Really good as a group. Edmonton's throwing everything at them. They're hitting them. They're throwing the puck deep. And they just take the punishment, move the puck out. Cam Ward hasn't had to be spectacular.
The bouncer came near George Laroque trying to fight his way through. A stick came up high. After it is Morrow. Then fed to the back. Spotcheck over to Stale. Some jamming at the front. Directed in front by Laroque. Spiked away by Commodore. Still they battle. Half forwards warming to the task a little of the Oilers here. Spotcheck a shot. Save made by Ward. Rebound poked away from Laroque. Brought back ahead now by Andrew Ladd. Taps it in and goes right after it with Stale. Good collision there. Cullen poked it on through. Under 2.5 to go. Second period. Recchi from Stahl and Stillman has broken this tie. Greg Adams lays it back in. Again, another change in lines for both teams.
Hey, Stillman deserves as much talk as any other teammate of his about being an MVP in these playoffs. He has been awesome.
A clinching goal in the Montreal series, the same for New Jersey. Centering pass is blocked. And then a Game 5 overtime winner in the third round against Buffalo. Ahead trying to get through is Whitney. A penalty is coming up to Matt Green.
Second period.
Brind'Amour skips it on back to Caverley. Has Williams and gets to him. Turned it to Brind'Amour to Caverley. And then Williams again. A pretty good strong side kill by the Oilers at the start there. Forced them to make some accurate passes. It's stalled into Stillman. Walking it on and then giving to Brind'Amour. Inside the box is Williams. To the back it comes to Stillman. Then over to Stahl. Drive is slowed by Stoll. And then able to play it back along was Jason Smith. And a penalty coming up against Carolina.
Justin Williams will go. Called by the official near center ice. Mark McCreary, who was in closer to the play.
Smith lifted it alone. Lost by Ward. Hemsky right to it. Angles it back for Pronger. The careful block. The lob and getting a piece of that was Aaron Ward. Nudged on back now to Smith. Then Pekka shouldered by Cullen. And he's able to turn and play it back out. 1 minute to go in the period. It is Commodore slowing it down. Carolina, a splendid third period team. They have given up only one goal in the third period on the road this year. Recchi, nice dance around, but it is blocked by Hemsky. Recchi right back again, freed it up to Stahl, and a penalty coming up. It'll be on the Oilers. Stahl, very deliberate now. Changed hands on the stick and swatted it along, and now Smith touches with 32.6 left.
Mark Recchi draws the penalty, cross-checking call. Brind'Amour wants to tap the puck to the right, which he does. Keep the puck in the zone.
It is Stillman. Then across for Stahl. Then Stillman. Drove it in deep. Stillman a drive off the tip of the glove of Markkanen and back down. Stillman has Brind'Amour ahead on the right. plays it to the left to Stahl. Left behind. Fresh from the bench is Whitney moving in. Fakes the drive. Whitney to the back. Brindamore across. Stillman there, but he lost it. And time will expire.
That was a big part of what happened.
As Mike Commodore handles the puck, an Oiler is released from the box. It's a 4-on-4 for a little under half a minute. Then there'll be about 45 seconds of a Carolina power play. Joseph Wasicek throws one across the net out wide. Commodore taps that one back in deep. Might be an odd man rush. It is Smith, but catching up is Wasicek. Smith able to roll away. Big one in front. A great save by Ward on Horkoff. A dump shot by Steos. And it's nudged right back out for Recchi. 2 seconds and one. And now the power play starts for Carolina as Recchi pressed hard to the boards by Ryan Smith. Back ahead, Steos, and lobs it back in.
Cam Ward, he makes it look so easy. Commodore had gotten caught off ice. The Oilers went to work, and Ward kicked it out.
Brought ahead by Brindamore, given over to Williams. Shoots one, blocked out. Another shot. Oh, what a great goal by Markkanen!
Markkanen has made at least three fantastic saves in this game. This is the third huge save. Rebound, quick shot. And that was labeled. Was that Brindamore with a shot? And here's the play by the Oilers. Smith shows strength, moves the puck across on Horkoff's shot, and it was kicked aside by Ward. Great goaltending at both ends. It's another thing Pronger talked about with Brindamore. His shot's improved, he said. Over the years playing against each other, he said Brindamore's shot has really improved.
This is Stillman out there, has Brindamore nearby. That's to his right. What'll he do? Decides on Brindamore. Then Stillman. Brindamore back to Stahl. Hands it over to Caverle. Five left power play. Off a skate, corralled by Jason Smith. Lobs it further, and the penalty box is empty. Full strength action. A minute and a half into the third. Game four, Stanley Cup final. Carolina leads 2-1 in the game, 2-1 in the series. Two nights from now, game five in Raleigh. Flip past the linesman, settled down by Markkanen. Pretty good challenge from behind by Doug Waite, and it carries him. Waite on the draw with Smith. To the back it comes to Ward. But then Hemsky. Which will be the unit that will strike, or will there be no more strike tonight for either? Harnstrom, but Ward.
Well, Peter Laviolette told us he didn't want to lose the game 2-1. He'd rather lose 8-7. I don't think he'd mind winning 1-2-1.
Well, he wanted chaos. At times he's gotten it. That forecheck was established very well in the second period by Carolina, I think. But in the third, now that things have settled and the penalty box is empty, we'll see if anything can develop for either team, or will it be just attack and resistance, which we've seen a lot of tonight. 17 shots to 16, Oilers. Wasicek's shot is deflected out of play. Pierre.
Right now, the Oilers coaching staff is imploring their players smarter shoot-ins, more puck pursuit, start spending more time down in front of Cam Ward. They've got to do a better job getting pucks in deep, winning races, and dominating play. John, you talked about Carolina taking over the game in the second period. In the first period, Edmonton owned the game because they had more speed and more physical presence.
Yeah, but you know what? Carolina's defense, with all that physical play by Edmonton, they maybe would bend a little, but they never broke. They took it. There's another offside here. The defense for Carolina was punished, but they took it. They're so experienced. It's unreal. And then you take a guy like Craig McTavish. He played 1,093 regular season games as a player. He's very experienced. He was the centerman that took the very last faceoff in a one-goal game in Game 7 for the Rangers in 94 to knock out the Vancouver Canucks. That faceoff was against Pavel Bure. You're not going to have panic, I don't think, Pierre, at the Oilers bench, are you?
No, you're not going to have panic, but part of the problem is the Edmonton Oilers power play is so anemic right now. You can take it all you want, but their power play can't get going. So all those big body shots on the Carolina defense had no impact at all. You think about
Warren McTavish, a big part of it.
It is Fochet away from Steos to Dvorak. Lobbed on, and Glenn Wesley hand-passed it ahead. It is off Samsonov and then Spotcheck.
By the way, Craig McTavish was the last player ever to play in this league without a helmet, as you saw in that last video work.
finished his career in St. Louis. Dvorak threw one in front. It came back away from Wesley to Pekka, denied by Vallin. Oh, some strong defensive play. A very experienced defense as Samsonov works to the outside to the back. Pronger and drive, and it went wide. Then back to Smith. His shot cut off and swung on by Wesley. Kept by Michael Pekka. Lob back in deep. Played along behind, away from Vallin. Vallin had some help from Stillman, then around behind to Samsonov. Samsonov then turning. He's got Pronger and banks it to him. Pronger slides it across. It's Jason Smith dumping it back in. Left behind by Pekka. Trying to punch it along. No luck there for Brindamore. Nice sachet by Samsonov. Samsonov crossed around behind. Back pass in front. And it carried off Brindamore and came across to Williams. Yep. And is lobbed back out by Stillman.
Mike Vallin, the defenseman, number 7, lost his stick. Corey Stillman, so smart. He gave him his stick. And then Stillman got another one from the bench. All that going on while the puck was in the Carolina zone. And Edmonton couldn't find a shot.
A chip shot that ricochets in the back pass attempt by Dick Tarnstrom in deep fails. Now it's nudged around behind and turning with that as Torres. To the back it came over to Green. Then to Tarnstrom and a shot. It went wide. Banked over for Ladd. Run into by Green, but not until he cleared it back.
Yeah, he took a hit to make a play. Did Ladd. Puck ended up out of the zone.
Ward dropped it back in. Andrew Ladd, 6'2", 201 from Maple Ridge, British Columbia, only 20. Aaron Ward moving in as Wasichek. Two-a-side board battle. Nearly 5 minutes played in the third. Recchi slides it across, and it's carried on by Frank Caberle and lobbed on back and chased down by Green. Recchi, short, choppy strides right back.
Smarter than others.
Go Oilers go was the chant thrown by Hemsky, ricocheted right back off Aaron Ward. Hemsky chased off by Caberle. Of the 6 defensemen used by Carolina, drive, and that ricocheted off another player out there in Kevin Adams. 5 of them are in their 30s. Is it age? Is it experience? Looks like experience in these playoffs. Ward goes back to play that, chased off by Horkoff. Pinching in without a helmet is Smith. Brought back ahead by Kevin Adams and handed on to Eric Staal.
That's a big line for Edmonton on the ice, but they couldn't get a shot. Hemsky, Smith, and Horkoff. They go to the bench for a change. They tried, but no shots.
Rolling the lines again, Carolina right back with it. Now as Morrow slams one off the pad of Ward. Grabbed by LaRocque. Tripped up on the play, Craig Adams. Puck dug out by Waite and played back to him. Adams sends it on to Waite. Chased down by Morrow. Doug Waite peels off and then glides behind the net. A little back pass in front. Flagged down by Morrow. And out of harm's way for the moment, stoked it on for the play by Pronger. Rem Murray had to settle things down, but did. Michigan State product lobs it back in. Ethan Morrow back for that. Out of the trapezoid, some trouble for Ward, but it's filtered on back away from LaRocque. Brought back ahead now by Whitney. And Whitney lays it back in. Fans are upset about something.
That could have been an interference call. Rare shift right now where Brindamore is on the ice and he's not against Pronger or Jason Smith. Rare shift for him with this matchup.
Crowd was really upset because they felt Doug Waite had hooked on to George LaRocque on a back check. That's why they were screaming.
And Hedekin also held on to a broken stick for a while.
This will be icing. Nearly 7 minutes played here in the third. Pronger and drive deflected in front. Only 3 shots in the entire period. 2 by Edmonton that have gotten on goal and 1 by Carolina. So Jason Smith matched up with Pronger on defense. It is Dvorak working up front along with Staal and Samsonov. Push back in, the veteran tandem of Vallin and Wesley go back. Wesley, an 18-year man in the league, has not won a Stanley Cup. Tonight he's playing in game 166 of his playoff career. Lob back by Pronger. Williams, Brindamore, and now Ladd are out as they want to get the Brindamore line off, apparently. Andrew Ladd has come out. Commodore grabs this. The only 20-something defenseman in the lineup tonight, and he will take this one back. An Oiler change. They get Ryan Smith, Sean Horkoff, and Alex Hemsky out.
This is their big line, the Oilers' big line.
Good hit by Pronger on Kevin Adams. It's back for Hedekin, and the shot went wide. Rattled on and turned off for a bit was Ladd, so it's Horkoff starting ahead. He's got Hemsky already and gives to him. Hemsky threw one in front, deflected. Smith with a pass. pass across the net, mount wide. On comes Big Joe Wasicek, bringing it on along with Kevin Adams. And again, another change for Carolina.
Hey, Big Joe hasn't hurt the Carolina Hurricanes. He has gotten more ice than I thought he would.
Smith's pass went off Aaron Ward, laid on by Adams, but kept alive by Horkoff. Then to the outside, Hemsky shoves it on across, turns it in. Angle from it, ricocheted off the defense, and Ward got in the way again.
Experienced defense of Carolina, the seams opened up. Edmonton looked like, okay, here's the big chance, and there's the experience of Aaron Ward breaking up the play.
There's a chance at the side of the net, and Markkanen blocked it down. Close in chance by Matt Cullen after a lot of probing on the attack by Carolina that you saw.
Oiler fans trying to provide the man advantage, trying to be the extra attacker for them.
Oh, Spotcheck is hurt. It is cleared all the way back, and pivoting away is Whitney, and Spotcheck shaken up now, headed toward the bench, but he has to meet the rush, puts the shoulder into Adams, he bounces off. Craig Adams bet one, Whitney shot it wide. Around near George LaRoc near the end of a long shift for the Oilers. Caromed it on back down, and it will not go for an icing. It's nudged around inadvertently by the referee, Brad Watson, and so it had to be picked off, and they got a change made.
Spaschek shaken up at the bench, absolutely tattooed. Battered by Eric Staal.
Commodore turns. Clock winking down to the halfway mark of the third period of game number four, and an offside is called with 10:02 to go.
Trainer Ken Lowe working with Spaschek at the bench right now. Spaschek was along the boards, and big Eric Staal moved across. The puck betrayed Spaschek, and boom, and he went in hard.
That's just a hard hockey play. Spotcheck's trying to protect the puck. Stahl's trying to win a race. Ken Lowe, the trainer, as you said, John is over there talking to Yaroslav Spotcheck. He is laboring big time on the bench.
I think he hit his face and visor and helmet right into the boards.
That was Pronger on Brindamore, and it's forced up into the mesh by Williams. Play halted here, past the halfway point of the third period, and it's still 2-1 Carolina.
Moore's been a tremendous story this playoff season, 12 goals for the Hurricanes. John and Doc, it's maybe not a big point night for him, but he does so much in terms of the little intangibles.
You know what he does, Mike? He makes the other team match up against him. Again, it's Pekka's line. It's that same pair of defense. Edmonton needs a goal, yet they're matching up to slow down Brindamore. Even if he hasn't scored, he's making the other team adapt to his line.
Pierre asked him before the game about being a target. He said, well, if I'm a target, then that means somebody else is going to be free.
Yeah.
Cranked back in by Pronger.
Good point.
Last night he had dinner with his parents. You wonder how many times as a youth it was a quick sandwich. Well, this one wasn't. It was pretty nice. Good for him. Played along now to the point and held there by Smith off Pronger. It came deep, and Pekka tried to sling one to the front, but Aaron Ward said no. Pronger a drive. Save Ward, and he paddled it away. A lot of traffic, and Torres is stopped by the goal stick of Ward. Still, they can't get out. Caverle decides he's going to let his goalie keep it.
Mike, there was a great goaltender here for a lot of years. His name's Grant Fuhr. Grant Fuhr never got rattled. Never. And this kid is the same way. Now watch, not only does he make a save on the big slap shot, watch what he does with a rebound. Torres is there. Here comes the big shot in a moment. Right here. For the rebound. Bad God. He pushed the puck away from all the Oilers in front. He turned that one into the corner. Remarkable calmness. Win or lose, his demeanor doesn't change. Grant Fuhr was the same way. Win or lose, he never changed with his attitude.
And Grant got a lot of surprises in those days. The glory years. That's an onside play. And a buzz went through the crowd on that one. I think they felt the Oilers clearly got away with one there. Smith hooked it around. Horkoff hit by Hennigan. Knocked down, and play will continue. Wasicek, and that's bounced right back near him. He slugged it back on, and so Matt Green will go to get it. 8.25 to go, third period. Mark Recchi has scored the last goal. It was with 4:04 left in the second. That broke a 1-1 tie. First goal to Samsonov. when leading going into the third period. Carolina in these playoffs, 7-0. In all their road games, this being the 10th. Recchia shot snapped up and held by Markkanen.
Another little pass by Staal, right?
Mark said absolutely, and that's a big factor in this game here tonight.
Hank's the guy that had that rink built in the backyard. Dvorak with one that came right back to him. Stood up there by Wesley. Coming by is Eric Staal. The duel with Jarrett Staal, and it's pushed back ahead now for Cullen. Moves ahead with Staal and Recchi. That came to the Recchi side of the ice. Protects pretty well. The back pass fails, though. Spacek is back out there. Good news for Edmonton. Is back on as Jarrett Staal dropped it back for a shot that's turned aside by Ward. That came from Stales. Now it's Pronger. Drive! Deflected. It went wide as Aaron Ward dove to the ice and got a piece of it.
Oh, baby. Mark Recchi turnover. Pronger wants one bad to tie it up. Remember, Pronger turned the...
Masani getting a shift.
He has the puck. Nice close off that time by Hedekin, and he played it ahead for Whitney, booted back out to center. Pronger is nearing a total of 24 minutes in this contest. And we are in the third period. It's not unusual for him to play over 30 into the 32 range in a 60-minute game. Hedekin lobbed it on around. Pisani to take it there. Dropped one, and Hedekin's right to it and plays it back out. U.S. Olympian put it all the way down on Markkanen. Clock ticks down to the last 6:35. The thundering ovations have sort of evaporated here. There's a restlessness, but also a concern.
Everybody, you can just feel in the building right now, everybody just very, very worried for their hockey club.
Torres turning, rifled it across. Arnstrom gave it up. Craig Adams can start it out. Connects back on to Brindamore. Has Stillman with him. Crosses. Brindamore holding now. 12 goals, many of them in the third period. Caberle able to step by. Shoots one. It's grabbed and held by Markkanen. 7 of those 12 Brindamore goals have come in the final period.
You like the patience Brindamore has when he has the puck? Here's Pekka moving in. Big hit on Hedekin. But the defense of Carolina continues to just hold their ground. They don't bend. They get pressured. I don't know if we've seen a rebound shot, or maybe not more than one or two on Cam Ward. Cam Ward deserves credit for either getting the puck when it hits him and he covers it, or putting it in the corner. But his teammates take care of people around the front of the net. He has seen shots, and he's not had to worry about many odd man rushes, and he's not had to worry about many rebound plays. Or, pardon me, yes, rebound plays.
You were saying a defenseman until he was 10?
Yeah, absolutely. Markkanen was a forward and a defenseman until he was 13. Cam Ward was a defenseman until he was 10. He was to play in a big tournament, a youth tournament, in the next province over in Saskatchewan. But their family moved to Winnipeg, so he missed the tournament. Was he upset? So his dad compensated by sending him to a camp, and he became a goaltender.
Oh, a shot by Dvorak is blocked again by the defense. Brought ahead by Recchi and thrown back on by Stillman. Spiked back in by Staal. Nearly tripped up, but he comes to the bench for another change. Oh, there's a confidence about Carolina you can just see out there now. Played back along to Ryan Smith. Dropped it on back for the carry ahead by Horkoff. With speed gaining the zone, trying to shake by. Commodore slugged it away. Tapped back along by Williams, but it came back to him. Calmly recovered and over to Vallin. And again back in. 5:02, 5:01, 5 minutes to go. Third period. Oh, and getting out of the way was Ryan Smith of a hard hit that came his way from Craig Adams. Got mostly the boards. Hemsky turning with it. Wiped out. Vallin able to take it there. Safe play is back out again. A two-on-one developing. It's Whitney lugging it ahead. And Craig Adams moves in, but he was hooked. There'll be a penalty coming up to the Oilers. It begins on the Smith hooking minor. And it comes back in on the offside very quickly off that draw. Smith the hook with 4:38 to go. 5 seconds have passed on the power play.
Smith is a defenseman. He was caught up ice trying to provide offense with a four-man rush. And on the back check, watch as he, whoops, my fault, puts a stick right there at Adams, who may have had a clean break. And that's why the referee made the call. And he sits now. Think shorthanded maybe, right, Mike? Morrow's on the ice, number 18 for Edmonton. He had four shorthanded goals on the season to lead Edmonton.
Horkoff and Pekka have scored shorthanded in the playoffs. Slade back out on the turning stick of Mark Recchi. Right now, he owns the winning goal potential. Recchi to the outside. Watched there by Morrow. Swung it back to Caberle. And wait. And along to Whitney. A lot of traffic. Nudged it over to Waite. Then back to Caberle again. Hands it across, and it's held once more by Cullen. Given to Caberle. Drive! And that deflected to the wall.
Caberle makes his power play go.
It is Waite again. Forehander directed back out again by Markkanen. To the outside. It's around to Doug Waite again. Halfway through the power play. Lifted back along by Caberle. Spotcheck cleared, but Caberle knelt to block it, and now it is brought back ahead by Rem Murray. Able to bounce off Whitney. He's got a man breaking stale. Got it through, and it's directed wide on the backhand. Oh, my. Brindamore starts it on back. Hustling ahead, Nicholas Baleen steps by a stray stick. Wedged off by Stale. Tips around behind. Dropped it onto Stillman. Looks over his options. Tries for Williams. It's corralled by Brindamore. Rod Brindamore settles it down, handing over to Commodore, then across to Valine. Shovel shot is deflected up into the... There will be 2:38 left when the penalty expires, barring a power play goal by the Hurricanes. It's Stillman there, away from Brindamore, pinching in as Valine. 10 to go. Lifted around, and it's away from Stillman. Stepping to it as Jarrett Stahl moves back out with Pekka. Lobbed it onto him. Gloved down by Commodore. Tries to shovel it along. Still battling from his knees, reaching for it. And we get a stoppage of play. The penalty box is empty.
Here's that play we were talking about with Edmonton shorthanded. Rem Murray, the coaching staff say he's the smartest player on the club for Edmonton. He feeds Stales, the defenseman, who did get a stick on the puck, but it just...
2.5 to go. The Let's Go Oilers chant resumes. Many of the fans here are standing. Nearly 17,000 of them watching their Oilers for the 10th time in these playoffs.
And Edmonton only 5 shots this third period. Only 5.
The last team to make the playoffs this year. The first one to qualify for the finals, these Oilers. 8th seed in the Western Conference. Trying to create some more magic here late. Smith drove it back in. Rattled around near Corey Stillman. Hedekin came by. Spiked away by Stillman. Knocked around in front. They scrambled for it there. Curling around behind and holding his Hemsky. To the back, Jason Smith. Drive! And that one deflected wide off the glass. Hemsky has it again. 1:50 to go. Back to Smith again. Drive! And that one blocked off. Rebound came in front. And it's Williams to get it. Cleared off of Pronger and back down. I didn't see if that last shot went all the way through or not.
No, the teammates for Cam Ward blocked 2 big blasts. Absolutely right. Boy, was he ever trying to get his teammates or his players' attention. Their players are exhausted. They couldn't change. And somebody just threw something on the ice. Linesman's got it. But Carolina, they don't mind the rest.
No, they threw a Super Bowl on the ice.
Well, it is stolen. Brindamore on the big draw. It's back to Pronger. Lays it around behind Valine there. Played back by Michael Pekka. He's able to get it to the point. Spotcheck walks it across. Then to Pronger. Shovels one back in. Pekka jabbed one off the goal stick of Ward. Spotcheck with 80 seconds to go. Angles one off Pekka. Chucked around behind. Back pass by Stoll fails. Taken to the outside by Samsonov. Pronger sent it across. Spotcheck couldn't settle it down in time. Pronger touches. Samsonov takes. Deals it back in again. Pekka can't get it to the front because of Valine. Off the outside it went over to Dvorak. Clipped off by Valine. Puck back out again to center ice by Stillman.
Puck to the outside the whole time. Nothing in the middle. Great defensive work.
Ward cleared. It caromed off Pekka back in. An offside called with...
Back to Hart to Pronger and set Hemsky up on the far side of the ice. Carolina wins the draw.
Markkanen must stay. Spotcheck to Pronger. 42 to go. Brindamore moves in. Slowed it down for Stillman. Again, it is stopped by Spotcheck. That saved some time. Pronger to Spotcheck. Charging toward the bench, Markkanen. Drilled back in. Away from Ward. Cleared by Aaron Ward. Off of Williams. Still up for grabs. Aaron Ward up with it. Long one that's deflected away by Stillman. Chased down by Pronger. 20 to go. Pronger's pass is off Hemsky. Picked up by Spotcheck. Nudged on to Hemsky. Couldn't get by Whitney. Whitney plays it back. And it's scaled on back for Pronger with 10 to go.
Valine was there. What a set of 6 defensemen this Carolina club has.
Can't make mistakes. Hemsky's pass is slow. Brindamore turned it back in. 2 seconds and one. Carolina has won the game. The Hurricanes have taken one out of two in Edmonton, three out of the first four, and win this one 2-1.
And I don't think the Edmonton Oilers registered a shot on goal the last...